I have a lot of diodes here, salvaged from all kinds of circuits. The black ones here are from computer circuits from the 70s, where they worked with diode logic. And here all other kinds of diodes, quite a few. These are also from computer boards from the 70s, 1970, 1973 or so. But I want to pay some attention to a special diode that I've also in my junk box, and that's the point contact diode. I think that's the right translation for the Dutch word puntcontact diode. And this is how that diode works. There's an electrode here, there's a sort of needle that enters here the semiconductor material. And on the point where the needle enters the semiconductor material, there is a specific effect, like rectifying. So these diodes were used in the past especially to rectify radio signals. This is another diode from the past, 1960 or so, and I hope you can see it, but here inside there's also a very very tiny needle that points into a piece of semiconductor material. This is the diode that I wanted to show. It's a Russian point contact diode. I hope it's visible now in the middle of the screen, that here's also a small needle, tiny needle, that touches the crystal, the semiconductor crystal. Hope it's visible. And this is the principle from the circuit that I have already explained. So I think it's a very interesting diode from the past, the time that making diodes was difficult. And in the very very first stages, when they made diodes and transistors, they added here a current, so that here in the crystal material there was a special place where there was a sort of burn-in place, and that effect caused the semiconductor effect. So the direction from the current in one direction